And hello, fellow tankers, Space Bandit here with another episode of World of Tanks. And today I bring you some credit grinding. Yes, I was grinding credits in my T95 E2 Tier 8 preferential matchmaking medium tank, American medium tank. And today I have two games for you guys. The first one will be my 2-mark game, and the second game would be just, just a little bit higher damage game for this tank than normal. So I decided to show them to you guys. I mean, I like this tank. I like playing this tank every once in a while. I think it's a really good tank, especially because it has preferential matchmaking. The mobility of this tank is pretty decent. The armor is not the greatest. It works sometimes. You know, if people shoot you into that sloped front plate, it can bounce a little bit, but the cheeks are weak. Obviously, that big tumor on top of the head is weak. But I do like the mobility. The power to weight ratio is not the best on this tank, so it has to get to speed. But once it gets to speed, it can go, over 55 kilometers an hour. It's quite fantastic, to be honest. So we run into a lot of tanks over here. And I was thinking at this point in time whether I should withdraw and drop or whether I should, you know, get into a fight. And I knew I was close to 2 marks over here, so I decided to stick it out and brawl it out. Why not? You know, sometimes you gotta take chances, especially because I was so close to the 2-mark. And I'm a top tier in this matchup, so I decided to just go for it. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna get up into this comfortable position here at J8. And this will allow us to poke over the ridge, use our gun depression on this tank. I can't remember what the gun depression is, but it's pretty darn good. -8 or -9. Degrees. We're gonna put a shell into this T29. We get tracked. We had to repair. I didn't really want to stay on top of the hill over there. And this Centurion is deciding to cross, so we're gonna have to drop here and start putting shells into this guy. So we put one shell. Our aim's all over the place, but we finally got it. We put a second shell into him. He tracks us again. And here we're gonna try to put a finishing shot into him, and that shell doesn't pen, unfortunately. Now I switched to heat because there are just way too many tanks over here and I need to be penetrating my shots and getting tanks out of the game, right? Now I see this Ragnarok yellowing in here again, and he's focusing tier 7 Swedish tank. Unfortunately, he goes down, but now he's on a reload, so we're gonna try to put a few shells into him. Now I'm not switching shells because I want to maintain my rate of fire, so I'm gonna try to go behind him or chase him. He actually makes a good play over here. He goes around, but we're gonna catch him anyway. We're gonna hit him and we set him on fire. So at this point in time, I thought he was gonna burn to death because I looked at him again, I think here, and he was like 126. I'm like, okay, well, he's gonna burn. I don't have to worry about him. So I switched my attention to this T29 because I thought he was a bigger threat. Here is a bad shot. I hit a good angle earlier, but then he turned and that angle became almost negligent and I couldn't really pan him. So we take him out of the game here, but unfortunately T29 tracks us and Ragnarok goes all the way around and puts three shells into us, and that was a bad play on my part. I should have focused the Ragnarok instead of T29, because if he didn't pen all of these three shells, I could have probably gotten out of this situation, but because he did, then I will not be able to. Here we put a shell into this Chieftain, and this is gonna be strange. Look at those shots. You see the reticle turn red, yet my shot goes into the rocks. It's gonna happen twice. Look at this again. Right here. This is stupid. I don't understand this game sometimes. Anyway, and I get taken out of the game just like that. So, quick, what is it? 4-minute game. I'm not gonna show you the rest of this game because my team won. It was a close one. My team was kind of struggling a bit, but we managed to finish the game off with a victory. So let's take a look at the end plates now and see how we did. So it's a victory. We made, 113,000 credits. Like, this tank is great when it comes to credit making. Even with shooting heat rounds, you guys be able to make credits. We managed to put out 2.8k damage, 2.1k assisted. Brings the total to about 4.9k combined, which is really nice for this tank. Class 1 mastery. Unfortunately, that wasn't enough for an ace tanker. If I would have survived, I would have probably had a massive game in here, but unfortunately it wasn't meant to be. Finished second on the team with 2.8k damage. Chieftain T95 finished first with 3k damage. Anyway, I just thought I would show you this quick game, especially because it was my 2-mark game, but it was quite a decent result, and it's just unfortunate that it couldn't be more than that, to be honest. But mistakes in this game will cost you guys, and that's what happened to me here. Anyway, let's skip to the second game of the evening, and second game is on map Heilbronn. Again, I'm a top tier in this matchup, and lately, I don't know, maybe because plus one, minus one, I was getting really good matchmaking in this tank. So yeah, it was fantastic to play it. So in the lower tier games, I try to play it a little bit more cautious. You saw me in the first game going right at it because, you know, I was comfortable with the position I was in and what I was going to do over there. But you really have to read and play off of the team, because in certain cases, greenies, you know, at tier 7 and tier 6, they're just going to go in and all die. And then you'll be left by yourself defending the position. So I'm trying every once in a while to play it passive, especially in this game. After my 2-mark game, I had the next game after that, and I got taken out really quickly. So that was really frustrating. So I decided to stick it out a little bit, decided to snipe. And I wanted to see who's going to snipe from the top of the ridge over here. And I realized that there's a tier 6 Hellcat and tier 7 IS-2, I think, premium tank. So I'm like, okay, even if I go forward and start spotting, I don't trust these guys to be penning their shots. So I decided to stick it out here and do some sniping early in game. And I've noticed that our, you know, light tank went balls deep over there at G9. He's not going to survive for much longer. And this is our tier 8. We're going to lose tier 8 really quickly early in game, unfortunately. We see a shot at the Tiger 1 here. Unfortunately, he passes. I wasn't able to put a shell into him. Now we see this Tiger P. And we're going to try to put a shell into him. Yes, we pen him. But Tiger P, even at tier 7, is going to be hard to pen for me with my standard shells, unfortunately. So we're going to have to swap to heat rounds, and heat rounds should go through him no problem. So we're going to have plenty of shots here. We need to make sure we penetrate those shots, guys. That's why it's so important. If you don't pen your shots early in game, it can come to haunt you later on. So it is important that you pen your shots. And in certain situations, you're going to have to load your premium rounds, and so be it. Don't be cheap. Use your premium rounds whenever you have to, right? So Tiger P is a tough cookie. Obviously, T26, E4 is a tough cookie, and that's the next guy we're going to face. But even shooting at T26, E4, we're going to try to shoot his weak spots, and I'm going to point that out to you guys. So this shell pens, I don't know how, but it goes in. But his turret cheeks, right? That's probably the best place to pen him, and that's what I'm trying to do. I'm aiming at his turret cheeks. As you can see, it's a little bit off to the left. This shot unfortunately misses. We're gonna try to put one more shell into him, but he's gonna disappear. But luckily we hit him, so I don't know what happened there. Now all of a sudden we spot this AMX 5100 crossing. My teammates put a shell into him, but he disappears behind a hill. And then we see this T32 Proto, and unfortunately first shell misses. But this guy, I don't know what the hell he's doing. Look at that. He's just driving forward. Tier 8, top tier, and he's just throwing his tank away. That's pretty brutal play, guys. Anyway, we track him in place, and he gets taken out. So it looks like we have a grip on this game right now. So we're going to move forward at this point in time. We're not going to sit here anymore. Obviously, the other flank, the other side of the map, or actually center of the map, 4 and 5 lane, it looks exposed at this point in time. And there's actually no one sniping from B6. So I thought to myself, well, that's probably the next step. We should probably get ourselves into B6 and start chewing down on the opposition that is currently sitting down on the 5 lane. In the meantime, I was looking whether this guy is going to come out here, but he was behind the other hill, so I didn't register that, unfortunately. Anyway, we're going to move forward. And at the same time, in a split second here, enemy's light tank is going to get spotted. Or am I 2-way ahead here? Okay, my memory doesn't serve me correctly, guys. I'm 2-way ahead, guys. I'm sorry. I'm 2-way ahead. First, we're going to go on top of this ridge, and we're going to try to snipe this Tiger 1 right there. We put a quick shell into him, but we're going to drop because the game is relatively close, and we don't want to be the target at this point in time. So we're going to lose our sixth sense, and we're going to come back out to the same spot, and hopefully we can put another shell into this guy. But unfortunately, there's no shot, but I am spotted, so we're going to drop here, and someone is targeting us, so we pull back luckily and we don't get damaged. Anyway, so this is the time right now. That's what I was trying to tell you. This light tank gets spotted, and it's a Lycan, so yeah, I'm gonna have my hands full with this guy, I was thinking. So I was kind of pinging the map. I was asking for help, maybe for someone to come and help me here. But luckily this Lycan is gonna come directly at me, So it's an easy auto-aim shot right there. And he changes his mind all of a sudden because he knows he's a one-shot to me right now. So he's going to turn around and try to run away. But he was running straight away from me. So it's an easy auto-aim shot. I didn't even have to aim. It would have been better if he came across to the side, to my left side. So he made me aim, right? So you guys remember that when you're in your light tanks. Make sure you squiggle. Don't go straight up. Anyway, so we see this Oni here. He's going to be a tough cookie to crack. So we have to load our heat rounds again, unfortunately. And we should be able to slowly chew him down. You know, chew down his health. Unfortunately, that's a critical hit. We don't see him here. He gets spotted again. So I should be able to start putting shells into him right here. Unfortunately, this shot misses. I probably shouldn't have been aiming at his turret. That would be an easier pen. But I'm trying to hit this little cupola, or rather machine gun port on his front plate, front end right there. Yeah, in hindsight, I probably should have been just hitting his turret. But regardless, we're printing those shots now, so we're going to keep on firing here. This one goes into his bottom plate, and he disappears again. Can we put one more shell into him and take him out of the game? Unfortunately, no. Again, I should have been shooting at his turret. Anyway, he's gone. We're leading this game right now. I'm still relatively full health, so this is my cue. We're going to go forward now. We're going to try to engage these guys that are sitting at F7. Now, one mistake that I made is I did not check the list, the enemy's list. So I didn't know the two tanks remaining. One is Tier 8 Autoloader, and the other one is Borsig, Tier 8 Borsig. And I'm going to realize that in a split second here. I'm like, you know what? There's an Autoloader there. I don't know who the tank destroyer is. And this guy shows up right here. And luckily, I turned the last second. So this is how you not throw your tank away at the end of the game. Even though probably this game was won already, I didn't want to throw it, so I went back into hiding. We're gonna just set up an ambush position right here. Hopefully these guys are gonna come out and start attacking us. At least we have a place that we can hide. But our friendly shows up now, so we can move forward a little bit. And Borsig started coming this way, but he gets taken out. So at this point I thought to myself, you know what, I don't think this AMX can take me out, so we're gonna push him hard and we should be able to take him out of the game. So we're going to go behind this train over here. We're going to put one shell into him. And we're not going to wait for our reload to complete, because we want this damage. So we're just going to ram him. And we just take him out. Just like that. And now only artillery left in the game. So pretty decent game for this tank, to be honest, guys. I mean, you don't see all the damage yet, because I had a lot of blind shots that I was firing in this tank early in game and later on when I was sniping from the top of the hill. But yeah, it's more than 2.7k, I can tell you that much. Anyway, let's hunt for the artillery and see if we can get him out of the game. Hopefully get some extra damage off of that guy. As you can see, this tank's mobility is quite nice. You have to get up to speed, but once you get up to speed, you move. Going up the hills is not that simple. Sometimes this tank struggles going up the hill, obviously. But yeah, I still like to play it. So we spot this M12, and I think here we made a mistake. I fired on a move. I probably should have stopped. He didn't have gun depression to hit me. So I could have stopped and probably put a shell into him. And that would put me in a nice damage number, and you'll see in a split second here. Anyway, it's a victory. It was a relatively close game. I mean, you know, I played it really safe for the most part. Just waited for greenies to kind of not throw their tanks away. That's all. But take a look at this. We managed to put up 3.7k damage, which is very, very nice for this tank, for this gun, especially being top tier, fighting against lower tiers. There wasn't a lot of HP to go around, so I thought this was a really nice result. Actually, if we would have hit the artillery, we would have been over 4k damage. But even though we had so much damage, we only finished with class 2 mastery, unfortunately, and I don't understand why. Probably because we were not up close and personal. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. That's it for today. Until next time, happy tanking. Space Bandit checking out.